20. Reserved keywords. A certain amount of words are being used in the core of Power Automate Desktop and can be used during development in the variables, subflow, label, or error block names. 19. Image recorder. To use the image recorder, make sure you're running the latest version of Power Automate Desktop. The image recorder is not available for web recording, it is only available for your desktop recording processes. It is very easy to turn on once you're running desktop recording. 18. Scroll on web page. Sometimes it can be pretty hard to scroll on a web page. Many pages are dynamic and load the content automatically. Therefore, it is important to scroll on the web page. There's different ways to do it. One of the easiest ways is to use JavaScript. So if you launch a run JavaScript function on the web and paste in this code, you will be able to scroll on any web page. 17. Send keys. Sometimes inputting text in a web application or a software will not work. As a solution, you can use the send keys. The send keys action sends keystrokes to the application that is currently active. It can either be sent in the background as a software input or can be mimicked like from a keyboard when sent as hardware keys. 16. Focus window. Use focus window when you're having problems interacting with SPIDE UI elements. However, sometimes depending on the nature of the app, a focus window action may not be able to bring the window into focus. In this case, send a click to the window and then use the focus to solve this. 15. Update Power Automate. Update Power Automate often as it's under a lot of development. If you have versions that does not have an update button, you will not be able to update automatically from the settings menu, but you will have to download the latest version instead. 14. Startup variables. If you want to build a process that has the ability to collect user input at process start, then you can add input variables to your flows. This will make it so that when you start your process, you will be prompted with a pop-up asking you to input information necessary for you to run the process. You have just created successfully a human in the loop process. 13. Switch from gateways. You should switch from gateway connectivity to machines. In version 2.8 and newer versions of Power Automate, machines are replacing gateway connectivity. To set up machines, you don't need to install a gateway anymore, but from Power Automate Desktop, configure and set up your machine. 12. Monitor desktop flow runs. If you log into Power Automate Cloud Portal and go to the Monitor tab and the Desktop Flow tab, you will be able to see all of your desktop flow runs. You will be able to see some basic information like the execution of the process. If you click inside of each one of your executed processes, you will be able to see information about that process, all the different actions that were executed, and also the data that was used and collected during the flow. Unattended flow run. If you want to build an unattended robot in Power Automate Desktop, we need to start in Power Automate Cloud and create a scheduled flow. In other words, a scheduled flow is a robot that will run at specific times and date with specific intervals. The next step we need to do is add an action that will connect our cloud flow to our machine and subsequently to the flow that we want to run. Once we have done this, we would have created an unattended robot.